Welcome back to Homesteading with the Heberts. Today we're going to go ahead and take care of Lord Farquad. So let's get to it.
No. Easy there, Lord Farquad. You're okay.
All right, guys. So we got Lord Farquad. So we're going to go ahead and take him over to the cone.
Him.
What?
Right there.
Where's
that his beak?
No, I don't know what that is. I'll look at it after.
Wait, that has a little head. Yeah. I almost feel nauseous looking at it, but like I can't stop looking at it because it's kind of cool. Like, this angle it doesn't face me except for the blood on the thing.
Alright guys, so my water is about 160 degrees right now, so I'm going to go ahead and grab Lord Farquad, and we're going to go ahead and try and scald him. This is a small pot, so I'm hoping he fits.
Back up. Beep, beep, beep. he's not a chicken. Well, he is, but he's food now. That's me. Flip him back over. I can't. That's more crazy. He smells like a wet dog. It's kind of nasty. Yeah, because all of his feathers are wet. Let's go.
Alright guys, so that was my first time doing a chicken. We've got it in a vacuum sealed bag now. It actually came out pretty good. It wasn't as bad as I was expecting it to be. I did have a few issues while I was doing it. If you're going to do this, make sure you have a really sharp knife. The knife that I was using was not very sharp. Unfortunately, it caused a little more stress to Lord Farquad than I wanted to. Because the knife didn't slice as cleanly as it should have. It still went okay, but would have been better if I had a sharper knife. And the same thing when I was eviscerating the chicken itself. It would have been nicer to have a sharper knife to be able to cut through the skin easily. In actuality, I actually switched over and grabbed my fillet knife, and that actually worked out really well. So again, make sure you have sharp knives if you're going to do this. But it went pretty good. Now we've got our first chicken. We know how to do it now, so the next time it'll go smoother. But again, guys, thanks for coming along. Have a great day, and remember to click that subscribe button. Can't wait to have soup with this guy.